A few years ago, when I took this job of doing high-rise, a friend of mine came in to visit. He asked me, like, what's your plans? What are you gonna do to kind of bring high-rise back into tip-top shape? And I told him I wanted to get into email marketing. A lot of people at high-rise were connecting high-rise to email marketing services like MailChimp and Constant Contact. And it was a pain in the butt. These things weren't working very well and was causing a lot of people's struggles. And I noticed, like, a lot of these people didn't really have a need to send out these really beautiful newsletters. They just needed to send something very simple. When I told my buddy about that, he was pretty excited for it. He thought, you know, hey, we could probably use something like that because we were just banned from our email marketing tool. They just closed our account. It struck me as strange. Why would they shut this guy down? This guy isn't a spammer. He runs a newsletter for a VC fund he works for, and they send out a newsletter to all these partners and people who are interested in investing with them. Everyone on this list of his wanted to be on this list. He told me it was because they only send out a newsletter update about once a year, and during that year, a lot of people's email addresses change. So when they send out this email list, tons of bounces happen. And I thought, oh, that's so silly. I mean, yeah, we're gonna be a better email service than that. 3 years later, I'm pretty sure I would have banned my friend too. We know a lot more about email marketing than when I did when I talked to my buddy. I'd say every day we have to ban multiple people for spam complaints, too many bounces. My buddy isn't nefarious, and a lot of people who are doing this in email marketing, they don't mean to be bad, but when they use our service to send a bunch of email that bounces, when a Google gets this stuff and they see all of these bounces happening, these email addresses don't exist, they assume some very bad things are happening. Blacklist us, they blacklist our IP, and that IP address affects many, many, many different customers. And so to protect the whole, we have to be pretty aggressive with the few. That comes to mind these days, because a week ago I did trick a journalist and a lot of people came back to me like, you're spending all this time on these bad actors. No, you should be teaching people how to send better email and focus on that. Well, we do. It's just that the people who do bad things using our email service are trying to send out tons of spam, are trying to send out scams. They're trying to send out phishing attempts, other nefarious things they want you to click on. And so it's something that we're constantly policing, using automated tools, using our support staff, manually reviewing things. I don't think people realize, unless you've run an email marketing service, how bad things are trying to police this. And so this isn't just a lesson about trick a journalist. This isn't just a lesson about, you know, this particular problem, but just keep this in mind next time you disagree with somebody. Really think hard about, have you been in a situation that they've been in that they would need to react this way, or that they would need to have this set of values that are different from yours. Running an email marketing tool's tough. I hope you are having an awesome week. Please hit the thumbs up. Please subscribe if you're new here. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye, everybody.